Hello and welcome back to an unboxing video. I would like to say that I was just kidding, but I'm actually not. But the point of this video will not be the unboxing itself, because I don't think I'm that kind of channel. But I normally make a quiz about my next projects, and you always guess what it is, even though I rarely gives a lot of clues. But this time I'm going to make it very hard so no one will guess it, because if someone guesses this, they really know their cars a lot. I'm gonna give some clues as well, but in these boxes are some spare parts to some of the other projects, but mainly spare parts for my new project. My new project is a big one. It's so big that it cannot fit in my garage. It cannot go through the door because of the height. That is actually a big problem, because at the moment the project got a big hole in the roof, no rear doors, no brakes. They are completely cut off, actually, because they were stuck. The clutch is not working, and the engine has not been started for 15 years. I don't know, a lot, not 50, but 15, a lot of years at least. I sold the US Buhanga, unfortunately, but I could not get that on the number plates that I wanted, so I could use it as a camper van, so I dropped that project. It was a shame, because it was so cool. But this new project is what is going to take over from that one. So it is a camper, or at least it can be used as a camper. And it's rare, at least in my parts of the world. I'm going to show you some of these parts, and most likely they fit other cars as well. So this is going to be very difficult. But if you know what I like, then maybe that's a clue. Let's take a look at it. And a bonus information, this box is 28 kilos, and the other one, the small one, is 15 kilos. So I bought some heavy parts, but as I said, it needs a complete braking system and a clutch. That's heavy stuff. So there's an oil filter. If anyone can guess what my next project is on the oil filter, I will be very, very impressed. Then there is a lot of braking hoses. The front calipers needs two brake hoses, because it's a double caliper or a twin piston. I actually thought that this car shared a lot of parts with other cars, but it doesn't really seem that way, because most of the boxes actually says the name of the car. So I'm not gonna show you the box for this, but this is the brake pads, of course. Here we have two rear brake cylinders, rear brake shoes, eine Lambda-Sonde. I don't speak German. That's for the Peugeot. Brake hardware for the rear. What is this? Oh, while shoving around, I noticed that, this is so silly, but I noticed that I could get this kind of clip that is used on many brakes to hold the pad in place. I need some of those, and then they were very cheap, so I bought 25. And take a look at this. I got 25 of these in a big bag, and all 25 is in a small bag. So 26 bags for 26 of those little clips. We are having an environmental problem at the moment. This is not a very good idea. Anyway, I'm gonna show you this, because geeky people will maybe recognize it. And I think geeky people are watching my channel, because I'm a geeky person. So at least I hope so. It looks like this. What is this? Ignition coil Sundspule. I'm pretty sure that's for the Peugeot. I have bought some parts because they were cheap for the Peugeot. I'm not sure that I need them all, but I just want to have some spares for that. Bremsesattel. Ah, that's a caliper. That's the braking caliper. That could also be a clue for someone who knows their stuff. Here we go. One big brake caliper. The clutch. The clutch is going to be difficult to change on this car because it is a bit complicated. Without saying too much, there are some drive shafts to address before being able to take the gearbox off. And also, this engine is a bit weird in the setup. I don't know if it's going to be hard, but it's different at least, because the camshaft is actually going all the way through the bell housing on the gearbox, apparently. It looks that way at least. So that's a bit weird, and I haven't messed with that sort of system, but that is a big clue to what it is at least. It must be the brake discs that's the heavy part of this box. Oh, and I also... No, I didn't buy drums. I hope to be able to salvage the old drums on the car. So yeah, this is just... This is only brake discs. Someone has dropped it, so I hope it's not in too bad of a condition. Seems fine. No, it's not a Lamborghini, but it's a big, big brake disc. So, that was all. The good thing about all of this packaging is that my wife got a company selling vintage Danish design lamps, and she needs a lot of packaging, so this will not just go to waste. It will be sent somewhere else in the world. Either way, those were all the parts. The project has not arrived yet. It is going to be a bit of a hassle to get it here because it can't drive, it can't brake, it is not watertight, and I cannot get it inside when it gets here, so it's a lot of issues. I'm considering trying to figure out to get a better gate for my garage door that is higher. I think the car is 2 meters and 40 centimeters, and my big garage door is 2 meters and 18 centimeters, so that's a problem. Maybe I can get away with putting some smaller tires on it, but either way, it will have to be able to drive to do that. So, guess away. For members, I'm going to post a picture of the rear of the car tonight. A blurry, bad picture that I took when I went to look at it. So you won't be able to exactly say what it is, but if you know your cars, then you will most likely recognize it. So, yeah. I can't wait to hear your guesses, and I can't wait to get started on that project, like always. I really hope to get the Peugeot running before it gets here, just to not have too much going on. The Peugeot is running, but through the MOT, of course. Hopefully I will do that this Thursday. We'll see. Either way, thank you for watching, and see you in the next one.